Okay, good morning class. Today we'll learn a new subtopic, that is speed time graph. Yeah, this type of graph. And before this you learn distance time, but now it is speed time. So what's the difference? What is it all about? So let's go, let's see. Okay, class, in a speed time graph, your vertical axis, your y axis, you represent the speed, yeah? Represent the speed, okay, this one. And then your horizontal axis, your x axis is represent time taken, yeah? Time taken. And and this is your graph. The gradient of the graph represent this one, the rate of change of speed with respect to time. Yeah, as you can see here, the speed is changing, it's going up, it's increasing with time. And if you find the gradient, yeah, your m, it is actually your a, acceleration. Okay. Before that, in your previous lesson, distance time graph, if you find the gradient, it is actually you are finding the speed. Yeah, the speed. Yeah. So that is the difference with speed time graph. So what do you understand by acceleration? Acceleration is this one, I repeat, the rate of change of speed. Yeah? The rate of change of speed, you see, the speed is increasing with respect to time. Yeah? We call it acceleration. That means the speed increase, change of speed. There is a change of speed. Yeah? So it's in BM, it is per chutan. Huh? But for distance time graph, this one, the distance is increasing with time, and you can find the speed. Yeah, so speed is different from acceleration. Huh? There is a difference, you can see now. Okay, as usual, you will first learn how to draw a speed time graph. So for example, then you are given a table, yeah, a table show the change of speed of Inci Azizul's car for a period of 5 seconds. So this is the table given to you. Yeah, so let's see, the first row is time and the unit is seconds, and you can see the seconds increasing. And then below is the speed with the unit meter per second. Yeah, this one meter per second negative one is actually equal to meter per second. Yeah, it's just that the way you write it. And for speed, you can also use the unit kilometer per hour. Normally kilometer you use hour, meter you use second. Yeah, and you can see here the speed is increasing. So question, draw speed time graph. Yeah, so how you draw? First you choose the appropriate scale. Yeah, and then you plot, and then after that you join. Yeah, with a ruler. So I've done it for you. Yeah, I've done it for you. So you must label, class, you must label this one, the speed with the unit. Yeah, you see the unit, you must label. You write speed and then the unit, you write time and then the unit seconds. Yeah? Then most important is you do the scale. You do the scale here, you can see. And from this graph, you see that the scale is consistent. Eh? Consistent. Eh? This one is plus 10. This one also plus 10. All plus 10. So you can use this. You can use this as your scale. Okay. You can see over there. And then for your second also, it's all consistent. So you can use. Yeah. You can use for your scale. So you plot. You plot all the points, and then after that, you draw the graph. Yeah? You draw the graph. This is the graph. Yeah? Simple. It's the same as the distance time graph. It's just that here it is big. Okay. Example 11. Okay. Example 11. The rate of change of speed of an aeroplane that is landing is given by the equation, this one, yeah, where V is the speed in kilometer per hour, T is the time in hours, yeah. So draw a speed time graph to represent the landing of the aeroplane with the range of time, this one, yeah. So first, because no table, you have to construct the table, yeah? You have to construct the table according to the equation. So, this is how you construct the table. Eh? You put time and then below speed with the symbol and unit. And then, you choose 0 and 0.5, yeah? It is 0 and 0.5. Why? Because the period of time is this one. You just take the lowest and the biggest, yeah, value. So 0 and 0.5. And then for 800, you calculate. You calculate using the... So when T is 0, yeah, when T is 0, so you just put the 0 here, then you get 800. And then when T is 0.5, yeah, T is 0.5, you just put 0.5 here, you get V 0. Yeah. Then next, you draw the speed time graph by plotting the points. Yeah, plotting the points. This is the one. Remember, you write the speed and the unit, and then the time and the unit. Yeah. And here, because you have only 2 points, so you can put this one at 100 here. Yeah. And 0.5 here. And then you plot the points, and then you draw the graph. Yeah? So you get the graph like this. Okay, class, so that is our first lesson, yeah, how to draw the speed time graph.